Automobile companies have a clear image of pleasing the customer with new technology, which is quite understandable, but they also have ideas about just how new developments, including autonomous vehicles, will change driving and the shape of our cities. They have ideas about the nature of trips in the city, and quite a number of vehicle manufacturers are actively working with universities and other research groups on what the cities of the future will look like. And it's not just about cars. We should be having more conversations with car companies, not to lecture them on what we think, but to listen and interact so our planning encompasses ours and their research and respects stakeholders and market forces. Richard Emery is the CEO of Nissan Australia. Nissan is not just looking at convenience issues. Social issues are part of the mix.
From our perspective, we talk internally around heading towards an environment where you have zero fatalities and zero emissions. So those two factors are key drivers in the technologies that we invest in. I think people's perceptions of autonomous drive, or let's call it driverless cars, which some people like to use the term of, is exciting for many people. I think what occasionally is lost is the understanding of what that really does mean in terms of the daily commute or the driving environment that we deal with. Because obviously car companies have got to the point with the technologies that we're all pretty confident that we can deliver cars that do all the things we need them to do to fulfill autonomous drive at the various levels. But whether society, whether the transport systems, the roads are ready for that level of automation, I think is the challenge for whether it be Australia or any other country around the world.
A link to the full interview is on the AITPM website, and in that interview, some of the issues Richard discusses include car manufacturers are not aiming for bland cars that are only used for the function of mobility, although some of the time that is their function, but at other specific times it will still be to enjoy the driving experience. The design of cars, particularly interiors, will change. This might be considered one for the rev heads, but it actually has a huge impact on how we use our vehicles. And if autonomous vehicles are so good, do we really need speed limits?